A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 26th Feb. On the front page you have Modi opens war memorial, hits out at Congress on Rafael. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi has inaugurated the National War Memorial near India Gate in New Delhi. So this is a National War Memorial. So this is dedicated to all the soldiers who have laid their lives in the wars which India has fought. So we had fought wars in 1962, 1965, the Kargil War, 1971 war, and even the recent soldiers who have laid down their lives. Then here you have owner of Pulwama attack vehicle has joined Jaish, National Investigation Agency says so. So the National Investigation Agency has tracked down this Anantnag student who is the owner of the vehicle which was used in the Pulwama attack. So here you can see the detail, the entire trail of how the inquiry led to the owner of the vehicle is detailed out here. And below you have this coverage on the Oscar Awards which were given, and they are also called Academy Awards. These are the 91st Academy Awards, popularly known as Oscars. So you can see the best actor, actress, supporting actor, supporting actor female have been awarded. So, and the best film is Green Book. So this may not be important, but then this is important for some other competitive exams when objectives questions are important and such facts are important. And the period is the documentary which Guneet Monga co-produced on pad machine, and it is set in UP village. So this is period, end of sentence, best documentary short which has been awarded Oscars. Then on page 5 you have IAF choppers roped in to bring Bandipur blaze under control. So this is the Indian Air Force choppers, helicopters have been roped in because it is seen that the Bandipur blaze, the forest fire has spread to such an extent that now water bombing sorties are being used to douse this raging fire. On page 7 you have this coverage on the Oscars for the best documentary short film to Guneet Monga, so regarding period, end of sentence. Then this is drought less probable this year. So Skymet, which is a private agency for weather forecasting, it has predicted that there is less probability of drought this year in 2019. El Nino conditions are also petering out. When there are El Nino conditions, then as they become strong, the chances of drought in India and less rainfall becomes more in India. So El Nino conditions are petering out, are reducing, and drought probability is less. Also below here you have Padman feels his message will reach global audience. So you should know about the famous Padman. Even Akshay Kumar movie was based on his work. The name Padman comes from that. That was the name of Akshay Kumar movie. And this documentary which has won the Oscars, period, end of sentence, is also based on his work. So you should know about him, Padman. His name is Arunachalam Muruganatham. Muruganatham. On the editorial page, the first editorial is before eviction. So this is regarding the Supreme Court order which was there in news regarding evicting forest dwellers whose rights have not been accepted. So if their claims have been rejected, then they are considered to be illegal occupiers and they should be evicted. And the Supreme Court wants states to act quickly on this process. So this is regarding that issue, the editorial here. And second is pre-poll gambit. So this is regarding GST being reduced for under construction housing. So the reduction in rates, it brings cheer to real estate sector but unsettles the GST regime, because as we saw in news yesterday again how input tax credit is not allowed under the revised lower rates of GST. The lead article, coalition of the concerned. So this is regarding multi-pronged diplomacy, it is said, which is important so that Pakistan is compelled to end its support for terrorist groups. And this is the correct prescription. So this is regarding e-pharmacies. It says the entry of e-pharmacies will bring down the price of medicine for Indian patients because they bring in a lot of competition, as we have seen with e-commerce. On the op-ed page, you have this case of Shamima Begum. So she is from UK, and she was around 15 to 16 years old when she took a flight to Istanbul and then to Syria. She had told her parents that they were going out for a day, but then she did not return. And you can see she was with the terrorist group Islamic State. So now Islamic State has ended and she wants to return, but UK does not want to accept her. It has cancelled her citizenship. So that is the entire issue which is discussed here. Then on page 10 you have EU Germany joint calls for Pakistan to act on terror. So we have seen how US, France have supported us. Now even EU and Germany have joined in supporting and making a call for Pakistan to act against terror. On international page you have Britain should hand over Chagos Islands to Mauritius. So International Court of Justice has given its verdict on the archipelago, which is still under UK control, that is Chagos Archipelago, which is home to the US military base of Diego Garcia II. Then below you have shutdown observed in northern province. So Tamils here in Sri Lanka, in northern province of Sri Lanka, demand answers on missing relatives. So there is UN Human Rights Council session which is going to take place. So ahead of that, they are protesting here. So the missing persons, some of whom have been agitating continuously for 2 years now regarding these are the relatives of these missing persons. This is the issue here now. So Sri Lankan government used all its might and ended LTTE. So when the war ended in 2009, you can see it was estimated by Amnesty International that at least 60,000 people have gone missing in the past decade. So this was the war against LTTE, the organization representing the Tamils in Sri Lanka and fighting for their rights. So these people, missing people as such, on that, after the war ended, reconciliation process began and Sri Lankan government set up a committee also, international community also put pressure on the government to look into this. So this was the Office of Missing Persons, which was set up in 2016, but then there has been no further development on this. So that is why protests are going on here. Then on business page you have Adani is the highest bidder for 5 airports. So Airports Authority of India may get more than 500 crore rupees in the first year of awarding contracts. So this is regarding contracts for various airports which have been taken in by, you can see, Adani. And then this is banks may set repo rate as benchmark rate. So this is the new loan pricing regime which may come into effect from 1st April. And this is regarding the news analysis on this airport privatization plan in which Adani Group has won bids for 5 airports. Then on page 14 you have ILNFS accounts can't be NPAs without NCLAT not. So they can't be considered non-performing assets without National Company Law Appellate Tribunal giving its permission. So this is regarding ILNFS issue, the infrastructure leasing company that come under stress, and now Appellate Tribunal will give the order. So its order says the order is issued in the interest of debt resolution plan of the infrastructure company. So NCLAT had as such given a stay that these should not be considered as non-performing assets so that debt resolution can take place. Once declared non-performing assets, then of course the value goes down. So this is the issue discussed here. Then on the last page, again, you have this issue of global warming discussed here. It says warming imperils clouds that deter hothouse conditions. So the clouds also, reflect the sunlight back into space. So if they are not there, then it could melt polar ice and lift sea levels by tens of meters. So this issue is discussed here. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asia.com in the current affairs section. Here we have the current affairs uploaded on a daily basis. The PDFs are made available, monthly PDFs are available, and even there is a separate current affairs course for detailed current affairs coverage. A sample video is also provided here, so you can avail this too. So that is it. Thank you.